Okay, welcome to my class. Today we'll discuss a new concept related to the circular flow of money, and this is leakages and injection. These are the two variables widely used in through the macroeconomics. So before discussing the meaning and the effects of the leakages and injection into the macroeconomics, into the entire economy, so let us see this circular flow of income in a two-sector economy. Circular flow of income, we have taken circular flow of income in two-sector economy with the financial sector. These leakages and injections takes place in two-sector economy with financial sector. It takes place in three-sector economy where government is there. It takes place in four-sector economy where external sectors are there. It means where import and export takes place. So let us see this circular flow of income. So here we are knowing that in a two-sector economy, in a closed economy, there are only two sectors. One is the household, another one is the firms. So firms, you are knowing the firms, they used to hire the factor services from the household, and they used to make the factor payments, and this becomes the income of the household. So in a two-sector economy where there is no financial market, the entire economy goes to the firms in the form of consumption expenditure. But what we have taken? We have taken the financial market. As you are knowing, that entire income of the households are not used for consumption. Some part of income are used for savings. Some part of incomes are being saved by the consumer or by the household. I have taken one example of the income. Suppose the total income, the factor income, the income earned by the household is 100 crores of rupees. Out of 100 crores of rupees, 80% of the income goes for consumption. So 80 crores of the rupees, 80%, 80 crores of the rupees goes for consumption. Rest of the money, which do not go for the consumption, is certainly saved. And saving is equal to how much crores? 20 crores. Let us see, I have written this 20 crores, that this is the saving. And these savings will go to the financial market, will go to the banks, and in the form of deposits. Bank or the financial institution, you are knowing, they used to perform the function of accepting the deposits and lending. They are also lending. It means one side they are accepting the deposit. So this 20 crores of rupees in the form of saving, this is called leakages. So what happened? This 20 crores money will go to the financial market, and this 20 crores rupees, again, what will happen, will be borrowed by the firms. So firms will borrow, suppose, 20 crores of rupees, and this will be known as the borrowing. This is known as investment, and this investment we call in economics is injections. So here I have written this saving is equal to investment, because in the closed economy, that entire income or entire saving is used for investment. Saving is equal to investment. It is assumed that saving is automatically invested into the economy. So saving is equal to investment. Saving is leakages, and this investment, this is called investment. So this investment is called injection. I think the saving is leakages, investment is called injection. So this concept is clear to all of you, and leakages, injections, this takes place. This saving is the example of, you know, of the leakages and the leakages of the two-sector economy where there is the financial market. But if suppose there is three-sector economy, the government is also there. So government, you are knowing, the government also used to impose different types of the taxes or collect different types of the taxes, and government, other side, government is collecting the taxes. So if the government will collect the tax, that is known as the leakages. So taxes are the leakages, but other side, what the government is doing, government is making the government budget, government expenditure. It means government spending is the injection. If suppose four sector economy is there, if suppose external sector is there, so we are importing, we are exporting. So import is the leakages, because when we import this, our some part of income, our money will go into the foreign countries. Similarly, the export, when we export, the money will inject in our economy. So export is the part of injection and the import is the part of leakages. So let us see what definition I have written. So leakages means withdrawals of money from the circular flow. Withdrawal of money. It means withdrawal of money from the circular flow is known as leakages. Second, it reduces the flow of income. This is the effect of the leakages, that it reduces the level of income. It reduces the level of demand of goods and services in the economy. It means that when the leakages will take place, when the people will start saving more and more, then certainly what will happen? The consumption demand will decrease. And certainly what will happen? The consumption demand will decrease, means production will also decrease. So I have taken examples of the leakages. One is the saving, another one is the taxation, another one is the imports. Other side, injections. Injection means introduction of incomes into the circular flow. Introduction of income into the circular flow, it increases the flow of income. It means injection increases the flow of income. So flows of income increases, it increases the level of demand of goods and services in the economy. It means the demand of goods, the demand of services will increase when there will be the injection into the economy. So let us see what are the examples of injection. Injections are investment. When more and more investment will take place into the economy, then what will happen? Certainly let us see the creation of the asset will take place, production will increase, and production will increase, employment will also increase. When employment will increase, then certainly what will happen? The consumption level will also increase. So here investment, government spending, if the government in three sector economy, when there is the government, when government will spend more and more money into the economy, then consumption expenditure, the production will increase, consumption expenditure will increase. And let us see the exports also. So this export also, if we'll export more and more goods to the foreign countries, then certainly what will happen? Our production level will increase. So at macro level, what happened? The leakages and injections, they remain the same. So if we want to make our economy balanced, that if we want that our economy should move into the balance, then in our economy, we should keep our leakages and injection equal. So there must be the equality. There must be the balances into the leakages and injection. I think the meaning of the leakages and injection and the effects of the injection, leakages and injection, and the examples of the leakages and injections are clear to all of you. Okay, thank you.